natural selection for the UWC. Eric Loy up in the crow's nest as we get ready to go. Our first match features the bizarre Norman the Belligerent against Alex Castle. Alex Castle and Norman have faced off several times. UWC online, you see Norman goes right to the bite. And there's absolutely no way to strategize against Norman the Belligerent. He just comes out of every field possible. Sometimes he'll wrestle you. Sometimes he'll just beat you up. Sometimes he'll just run into the crowd randomly and abduct somebody. He comes off the ropes, and lands a fist right to the face of Castle. And Castle, shocked, gets a two. And you see that odd mannerism of Norman the Belligerent. These two have faced each other several times, and Castle at one point had left UWC saying that he wasn't going to have anything to do with it anymore, came back and attacked Norman the Belligerent, leaving him laying in the ring, which set up this match. And you see Norman getting dumped outside by Alex Castle. Castle is not one who likes leaving things undone. You see Norman getting right back up again. Block and a headbutt. Wow. That'll hurt both of them. We know Norman's got a hard head. And jumping off the ring apron onto Norman is Alex Castle into the front row of seats here in Georgetown. It is UWC natural selection. And coming up a little later on in the show, we've got that 4-on-4 tag match, elimination, the natural selection match. We have the UWC championship on the line. We have a award on a pull match. And we also have the career on the line match between Aaron Matthews and Jason V. Right now, Alex Castle going to work on Norman the Belligerent off that second rope. Norman is belligerent. He's also resilient. But Alex Castle is motivated. And some would say sadistic. Motivated and sadistic are a very dangerous combination. And a pound to the back of the head with the elbow by Castle. And now, chin lock. You notice he gets some extra leverage on that by standing just above that middle back. It's going to be a little tougher for Norman the Belligerent to come out. The referee asking if Norman's going to give up. That's not going to happen here. And jumping on the lower back is Alex Castle a second time. And he's getting back up again a third time. Whoop, no one there. Got out of the way that time, but right back on top of Miss Castle. Into the corner and another headbutt. And throws him into that far corner. And again, this has varying effect on Norman the Belligerent. Sometimes Norman does it himself. Now he just walks right into a right hand and down he goes. And you can see Alex Katz is showing what he did to his hand, and a quick jab, a second quick jab, and a third. And now Norman trying to get some offense, gets his foot caught, and down goes face first into the mat. Off the ropes, there's that boot. That talented foot of Alex Castle, which he hit repeatedly over and over again in the corner. We thought that might have taken old Norman out for a while, but that doesn't seem to have done anything other than bring him to this match. Now a boot to the back of the head. I wonder what Alex Castle is looking for in this match, whether he wants just a win, because he hasn't been able to beat him yet, or whether he wants to punish him. Norman just wants conquest. That's what Normans do. And again, just pulling at the face. And Alex Castle working him over. Castle starts to work on him. Crowd trying to get to Castle, but it's not going to work. Forearm to the back of the head. Rings him up. Snapmare. Down goes. Down goes Norman. Off the ropes. Second time in. Oh, into a sleeper hold. How about that? A sleeper on the mat. You can see he's really got under the chin and really good leverage here on Norman the Belligerent. Now, in order to get out of this, Norman's going to have to either turn into him and get up. Turns into him a little bit, maybe relieve some of the pressure. Now it's down to a headlock as he does get up to his feet. A couple of forearms to the midsection. Norman comes off the ropes. Ducks under and goes to the, doesn't go straight through. There's that ramrod headbutt of his. Wow, and he slides down, punches to the face. And again, the unorthodox. And that could pull his arm right out of the socket. Quick cover. Two. Just gets the two count on Castle. Unorthodox isn't the word to describe the mannerisms and the ring technique of Norman the Belligerent. Yeah, I don't think I can come up with the right word. One of his favorite maneuvers is to whip the guy into the post. And there he goes again. He'll do this six or seven times if they'll let him. And sometimes he'll let the other guy do it. Hard into that upper ring post that time. Castle calling for timeout. And Castle certainly no favorite of the crowd here in Georgetown. Many, many times he has shown his disdain for the crowd in a quick cannonball jawbreaker by Castle. You can see where Castle trying to think ahead. Sometimes it's very hard to think ahead of a guy who has no direction. And as you can see here, it drives right into the foot. But that just turns him around back into the corner. Here comes Castle, and Castle lands the knee. And now he runs back in and lands the foot again. He just keeps doing it. And up for it. Forearm that time. And Castle, what am I going to do now? Back in the corner. And now comes off and lands that big boot. And Castle is trying to think ahead. Again, when a man changes direction as much as Norman does, it's hard to stay ahead of him. Kind of an axe kick to the back of the head. And Norman, and he says, ask Norman if he's done. Castle is absolutely winded at this point. And stomp on that. And says, ask him. Nope, Norman's not going to quit. And what is he doing? He's unlacing a boot. He is unlacing a boot of Norman. Is he tying his boots together? Well, I can tell you this. In 10 years of doing this and several years of watching wrestling, I've never seen that happen. Now he's got his boots tied together. And Norman's shaking the ropes on his way up. Normanizing his way up and tries to go forward and lands flat on his face. Doesn't even realize his boots are tied together. He can't get around. And you can see the sadistic nature of Alex Castle. He's not even attacking him. He's just taunting him. And again, he goes down. Just watching him beat himself. What's Castle going to do? He's trying to figure out something to do. But he's just enjoying himself too much, I think, at this point. And down he goes again. Castle really just enjoying this a little too much. No, fires back. Got too close that time. And there's that obnoxious headbutt. Oh, and a kick to the midsection. Trying to take advantage of the immobility. Really, the referee could stop this and allow him to fix his gear, but he's going to let him go. Got too close again. Norman goes into the ropes, comes off, stomps on him. And a cover by the belligerent one. Two, just a two. And Castle getting too close. And there you go. You could see that mandible claw that he's used before. Castle in the corner. Norman wants to throw him out, but oh, can't go. Just reverses and slaps down to the mat. And really, there's not a whole lot Norman can do if... Oh, now look at this. Setting him up, brings him in, blocks the boot. Locks at that time, comes from behind, he's got a sleeper hold. He's got a sleeper, he got too close. Got too close. And a little mule kick from behind. Jumping DDT. One, two, three. There you go. Well, just too much to overcome for Norman that time. And Alex Castle finally gets the win. Almost overplayed his hand. Almost overplayed his hand, but that tying the boots together. Hell, if you've got a guy who runs all over the place, make sure he can't run. Alex Castle does get one step ahead of the man with no direction and gets the win. Just our first match on Natural Selection. Surprise, and it's good to see DaCobra back in the ring here at UWC. I've watched this young man from a mere stripling, and he's definitely bigger, stronger, more experienced, and he is not one to back down from the challenge. Formerly known as the Man Without Fear, now the Muay Thai Warrior, DaCobra, and of course the Warden and his twisted psyche. Takes a right hand and delivers one, and it's a slugfest now in the ring. And there's those talented feet, and whoa, going right for the headlock. Gonna try to stop it right now is the Warden. Yep, oh, and the ropes coming off. Headlock. And DaCobra is down. First time of this match. Tips himself up, and no. And the Warden steps out. I've seen this man, DaCobra, do some amazing things in these wrestling rings across the Midwest. He has been off wowing crowds in other parts of the Midwest for a while, but he's back in the ring now trying to get that online championship, and he's going to bring the Warden back in from the outside. And meet him with a right hook. And a second. And a chop, and down goes the Warden. A quick cover. Just a two. Now, the announcement wasn't made as to who the opponent was until Cobra came to the ring. So, really, Warden has had no... Oh, look at this. Nice fireman's carry. Cobra trying to kick out, and he does. Just belts him right across the mush. Now a chop. And a standing drop kick. And the Warden is down and floundering a bit on the canvas. Cobra setting something up in the corner. The Mai Tai Warrior. Now circling his man. Those kicks can decimate a man. And again, it's just a solid boot. And another one. Ooh, a big bridge back. And getting himself right back up is the Warden. And boot, down goes the Warden that time. And a cover, one. And pushing his way out with a Cobra. He is a flyer. That second rope. But it's taken out by the Warden. A little bit too much play to the crowd that time, and landing on the back of his head is DaCobra. The Warden now going to take advantage of this. And a knee to the back. Another knee to the back. Cobra trying to push him away. And Warden's not going to go for that. Once he finds something, he finds a weakness, he's going to hang on to it. All right hand. Ooh, a punch to the lower gut. And blocked that time, but goes to the face and nails one. And the Warden's in charge right now in the corner. Whips him to the far corner. Oh, it's hard. And Cobra is down. See right behind referee Mr. Rife that bow stick, if you will, of the Warden, which has gotten him a championship, the online championship for the UWC, which is what the Cobra's trying to get to right now. The Warden peels off part of his covering. Now, again, whips Cobra into that corner in his back. Definitely hurting at this point. We've seen some already in just our second match, some hard, hard landings on the turnbuckles in this UWC ring. Going right back to him slowly, methodically now is the Warden. You're gonna whip him again. He's reaching for something. And instead, nope, just powers a right hand to the mush as Cobra tried to reverse things out. And pushes him again. You're gonna whip him again into that corner. Nope, up and over goes Cobra. Off the ropes, missing that time. Second rope, cross body block into cover. One, two, and no. That's how fast that man can explode. Off the ropes again. That time he just ran into a double axe handle. All the momentum supplying the blow that time. Look at this. Going for the eyes of DaCobra. Have you seen those eyes as he comes to the ring? You know how focused he is on his opponent. A knee to that back. And again, that's going to be a problem for Cobra. Cobra certainly a lot more, I would say, ring-wise than when I first saw him several years ago. He's been in the ring with the strong, with the fast. Not a whole lot's going to surprise him. But I don't know if he's been in someone with as twisted as Warden before. A couple of elbows to the midsection. Cobra, again, goes to that right hand. Snapmare, no. Tried to go into the ropes. Oh, a little matrix action that time. Off the ropes. Catches him with a sort of a leg lariat. And now Cobra's going to crawl over for the cover. One. And he makes it to the ropes. And I got to tell you, Cobra's pulling out all the stops, but the Warden has been a half step ahead. Not a full step, but a half step. Remember, the Warden just has to survive to keep his title. Part of the warden's mask is gone. He's losing his parts of his mask as he goes. Now, oh, fireman's carry. Standing. And a cobra fights his way back out of it again. And double chop that time sends the warden down. But he goes right back to the corner. Cobra looking for some crowd support. And some extra momentum as he heads into the corner. Lands that foot. Warden rolling into him and spinning round kick. Warden is down and maybe out. Here we go. One, two. Oh, and he kicked out. Ah, that was... That spinning round kick landed square, folks. And now it's Cobra. He's got a lot more weapons in his arsenal, but it's very tough when you've got a masked man in the ring to read his expression. You can read his body language, but he can also play some possum. I don't think that the warden is playing possum here. He's literally running to a buzzsaw. Now Cobra, spinning. Back kick to the midsection. Whoop! Brings him up and over, and there it is, fireman's carry. Look out! Plows him right down. Cover. One, two, three. Oh my gosh. Wow. Wow. Now that, ladies and gentlemen, is an impressive win. The warden finally got him up and wow. That's all I can say, folks. The Cobra put up quite a fight and had the warden reeling, and out of nowhere, the warden put on the finishing blow. The warden is still your UWC champion. We've still got a lot to go here on UWC Natural Selection.
Are we ready for tonight, guys?
All right, let's do it. Yeah, we're going to do this because I'm going to show you guys. I was in the very first one of these things, and I'm telling you how it's going to go down.
Bo, listen, I don't care if you were the first
one. Oh,
what?
I was here before you.
I don't care.
Remember that.
Hey, you remember that.
I don't
care.
Hey, all of you, knock it off. Look, they've got some speed. Okay, we've got the brains, we've got the power. Now let's knock this crap off and go out and take care of business.
Yeah, I bet he did.
Yeah.
Champion, Illinois, he is Harker.
you see him, Harker Dirge and Travis Weir. And we're already heading toward that belt, that pole with the award on it. The award says Matt Cage. Well, Travis Weir won that from Matt Cage earlier. Travis Weir interfered in a match that cost Harker Dirge the UWC title. So Harker Dirge took something that Weir was proud of, and it was that award he won from Matt Cage. So there you have it, Matt Cage's award on a pole, and the first one to bring that down will be the winner. And you can see bell ringer sends Weir back. Harker Dirge, this elbow to the top of the head. Dirge has almost been chomping at the bit to get his hands on Travis Weir in some way after Weir cost him that title in a match with Blake Reed earlier. Now top to the head. And blocked. And trying to separate the fingers of Harker Dirge that time. And trying to force Dirge down, but I can tell you, Dirge has a lot more power than you could expect. And while Weir is the bigger man as far as weight goes, perhaps stature, Harker Dirge can certainly rely on his own strength to get the most matches. And a couple of shots by Weir to the gut, little quick jabs, and then a elbow to the face. And remember that the idea of this match isn't a pinfall, isn't a submission, although I imagine both wrestlers will be beating each other up pretty good. The object is to get that award from atop that pole. Elbow to the back of the head for Weir. And now a nerve hold. Really is a disqualification is not really a disqualification type of match. So really you can do just about whatever you want. Couple of quick uppercuts that time and a double axe handle to the back of Dirge. Dirge comes off the ropes, boot to the midsection. And a reversal. Dirge goes into the ropes, comes up, beats the clothesline, down he goes. Weir not going for the award. And he goes for the elbow and misses. And now he's a little ways from that title. Remember, whoever gets that award wins the match. Whoa! And landing hard, Travis Weir that time. We might have had a Harker Dirge pancake if that landed. Now Weir's struggling to get to his feet. A drop kick, and Weir goes out of the ring. Weir goes out of the ring and all the way to the bell table. Dirge says, "Oh, I'm not ready. I'm not ready to go for that yet. I want to put some hurt on Travis Weir." Now Weir decides he's going to go for it. Dickie Wabash runs away, which is probably the prudent move on his part. Quick shot to the kidneys. Now punch to that forearm that's already been injured. And trying to reason with Harker Dirge at this point probably isn't going to do much good. As he slams that hand into the mat, Dirge really just taking the opportunity to punish Travis Weir. And oh, down across the top of that chair. Again, that hand. And he had hurt that arm before, I do believe. That right hand, that's going to be tough. You see that right here? Oh, he's going to use that metal side of the ring. And he just pounds it across there. And Wabash beside himself on the other side of the ring. The Wabash Talent Agency taking their lumps in this one. And Dirge, thrown into the ring post that time. And that time. Weir, almost out of desperation, throws Dirge off. Rolls into the ring. Wabash says, go get that ward and let's get out of here. Dirge is back in the ring. Weir starting to hit up, but his arm, I don't know whether his arm's going to let him get up there. He is right-handed. Dirge making his way over and hits that arm and elbow. And now it's Dirge climbing up. Weir comes over and grabs him by his feet and oh, head first into that top turnbuckle. And oh, that's as good as a punch. And uses its war on probably not the smartest move by Weir, but he's thinking more like a wrestler instead of a person who's injured at this point. Tries to slam his head into the turnbuckle, and Dirge, having none of it, tries it again, and no. And head first into that turnbuckle goes Travis Weir. Weir looking for somewhere to land. Knocker says, well, how about that top turnbuckle again? Nope. Left jab, right cross. Into that side, and oh, Dirge has got on top of him. Wabash saying, please don't do this. And Travis Weir, face first down. I'm not sure he's gonna get up. Harker Dirge. And coming over and rolls the man over. And now on top of him and just going to pound away. Now this is what Harker Dirge wants this match. I really don't think he cares less about the award. And then Dickie Wabash says, come on, stop. And Dirge says, let me get a piece of Dickie Wabash here. And now Travis Weir trying to make his way up. Trying to use the referee as a stepping stone, and Weir is punched in the back for his troubles. Thrown into the far ring post. Dirge misses with that knee. And he hit it square too, and a clip. Clipped that knee. And now Dirge is down, and he's going to have a hard time climbing with knee problems and getting right into digging away at Harker Dirge. Here's Travis Weir now grinding his face to the mat. Weir, if you can, I would suggest going up to the, getting that award and getting out of here. Pulls him down by that leg. Now going to do some more damage, just punching the back of the knee. A very tough area to defend. What is going on here? A spinning toe hold by the big man. And just out of the reach of Harker Dirge. He's got it on well. Keeping it away. Dirge is, there is not a submission match. He pushes Dirge away. And does do it again? Yeah, but no, that time. Weir pushed into that turnbuckle. Now he's gonna climb. He's gonna go after that award. He's on his second turnbuckle, trying to get up to it. And Dirge has a hold of him and throws him away. But Dirge landed on that knee as well. So now we've got two injured athletes in that ring. The right arm and hand of Travis Weir and the knee of Harker Dirge. Crowd trying to get behind Harker Dirge. Standing on one pin, is that going to be enough to take care of the big guy? Left jab, not as much steam on it. Tries to land an elbow, really not a lot of steam. If it comes off the ropes, lands an elbow. Stunner! Gets the cutter on him. And now, both wrestlers down. I don't know how anybody's going to get up to that pole. Referee really has nothing to do here. There's no count. Dickie Wabash pulling his hair out. Travis Weir hanging on to the boot of Harker Dirge. Dirge standing up. Can't reach him. Can't reach him. Oh! Weir down and Dirge to the ropes. Gonna try and pull himself up. We have seen so many matches of Harker Dirges over the years. We've been able to pull from a reserve. And now Dickie Wabash getting in to try and be a part of it. Nothing illegal. He pulls Dirge down. Now Weir is going to the corner. Weir going to the corner. He's up to that second rope. He's almost there. Wabash is down. And Weir is down. Oh, no, no. Oh, my. He'll be singing soprano, Ma. Weir just get punched in the top of the head. Punched again. He says, oh, smacks Dirge. He smacks Dirge a couple of times. Just so close to that award. Dirge pounding away. And one last time. Weir about ready to go down. Look out. He's down. He is down. Again, pulls from that reserve, that almost inhuman reserve, and beats Travis Weir for the award, and beat Dickie Wabash as well. Weir down, Wabash down, and basking in the glory of another win here at UWC, Harker Dirge. We have a lot more to come. It is UWC Natural Selection.
Well, you know something, folks? Normally, when you see me back here standing with the wrestlers, we're in a completely different situation, and I'm asking them questions about their big match tonight. But the difference here, I'm actually involved in this match. Why am I involved? Because of that snake-in-the-grass scumbag, Bradley Dupree. Bradley Dupree, I know you're going to watch this. I know you're going to see everything, and I'm here to tell you. I'm only here to get my hands on you, because I got the crazy man from Hell's Kitchen back here. I got the champ on my team. Bradley, it's going to be me and you. And you know what? I'll let my boys here take care of the rest.
You know what's funny, John Stone, is I've been in many of these matches that UWC has had, and I've been in the ring with most of the competitors that are in that match. And guess what? I've beaten every one of them. So I know the statistics of this match, and I know how to bring you a victory home, and that's exactly what I plan on doing.
Oh, yeah. Tonight, it's not about the biggest guys, because all Team Dupree is big jack guys. It's about small, athletic. I'm gonna go through alleys tonight. I'm gonna tear down Team Dupree. Joey, I've never been in one of these matches. Never fought for the tag belt either. You guided me to the tag belt. You guided me to win tonight.
No. Dupree, snake, grass, yes.
Yes.
But, Bo, you cheated. And I don't like cheaters. After them talking, my flat face is off.
Easy. You see what I'm dealing with here? I got this guy. He's on the brink right now. I'm just telling you this. We got to end this now. Dupree, you started this whole thing between me and you, and tonight, this team is going to finish it. Yeah.
We're coming for you.
Easy.
Yeah.
it's all broken loose. There's four men. Tag, as you've seen, it will not be Bradley Dupree in the ring, at least there. He's going to leave the ring right now, and right now it's four on John Stone. It will be, in fact, Cecil Cerveza taking it instead. Now Stone getting bullied up. And whoa! A big splash on Cecil Cerveza. And another splash. And going to the top rope and landing on everybody is Shank Barzini. And suddenly the tables are turned. Well, certainly Team John Stone dealt a bit of a setback as the former UWC champion. Oh, Tornado Jones tries to jump under this into everybody, but nothing happens there. Now Joey O'Reilly tries, and everybody lands on that one. And now Shank Barzini lands on everyone, and everyone goes down. That guy's Chris Crazy. Now remember, it is a four-man elimination. Oh, I hope John Stone's not going to jump out there. No, he's going to, yeah, he's officially got the start of this match. And it's Cerveza and Joey O'Reilly in there right now. And Cerveza found himself without a match. So he decided to become part of the match. And now he's in the wrong corner. He's in the John Stone corner. And a tag into Shank Barzini. Left open, and Barzini throws his own head into the gut. So Bradley Dupree finds a doctor to give him an excuse to not put himself on the line. Now a diving headbutt and by Barzini, and a cover, and nope. Remember, it's not just one pinfall that will win it. It will have to be an elimination of all four men on one side. Pinfall, submission, count out, or disqualification. There's a slam. Tornado Jones comes in. Slam on top of him. Cover, one, two, three. Whoa, I thought that was three, but that was about two and a half. Now, whoop. And down goes Cecil Cerveza. Cerveza not making the tag, getting a couple boots side to side. Now look at this, up on the top rope, and across goes Cerveza. And he is being outrun by the Tornado. Oop, look out, and now the Tornado, well, doesn't go out all the way. Nails him in the midsection. Wallace tries to charge. He gets nailed too. A tornado warning off that second rope. Oh, just drilled him. Cover. One, two, and pulled out. Ooh, that would have been an elimination too, but Vandy, Mark Vandy came in. Tornado Jones trying to set something up and up. Nope, thrown away. And a drop kick. Tag into John Stone, and here comes the big redhead. Oh, a left jab. Another left jab. And look at the man go. And a elbow. Cover, one, two. Oh, just a two count. Oh, I thought sure the bionic elbow would do it. In comes O'Reilly, and in comes Bo Sawyer. Swing and a miss. O'Reilly off that second rope, catches him, clips him with that kick. Tries to go in the corner, and Sawyer has him up and over. O'Reilly gets his kick blocked and gets nailed. That big meat hook fist of Bo Sawyer. What's he going to do now? Oh, this has the potential of a lot of damage. This is beyond an ultraplex. Wow! He brought him way up and down. Cover, one, two, and oh, I can't believe he kicked out of that. He had to bring him up and over the top. And now throws him into the boot of Mark Vandy and tags in to Spencer Wallace. Spencer Wallace stomping away at Joey O'Reilly. The tag team champions, O'Reilly and Tornado Jones, are in there for Team Stone. And right now, it's Tornado Jones. It's Joey O'Reilly getting the worst of it, bitten by Spencer Wallace. Now into the corner, and in comes Mark Vandy. Vandy, again, using his tag team partner as a weapon. Throws Wallace into O'Reilly, and now a cover. One, two, and no. Now remember, O'Reilly and Jones defended their championship against Vandy and Wallace. Headbutt's not going to do it either. Also defended against the former team of Rough Cut, but of course Josh Stone up and quit after that loss. Cerveza back in, gets the power slam, comes off that rope. Short leg drop and a cover. One, two. He grabbed the near leg instead of the far leg, as many wrestlers do, and only got the two count. Tag in to Bo Sawyer. And an uppercut. Sawyer, side of the head now. O'Reilly firing away, off the ropes, and whoa, just about got his head taken off that time. As he smashed on the back of those trunks, and he means it. O'Reilly tries to kick, nope, swing and a miss that time. Comes back with a heel, gets the kick, now tags in Shank Barzini. Elbow. And comes behind, oh, backslide. One, nope, just a two. Barzini now runs into the knee. And now into the wrong corner is Barzini, and the tag in to Spencer Wallace. And a quick uppercut to the short ribs. Now Wallace in control, a headbutt. It's one of Wallace's favorite weapons. And Vandy gets in the boot. And getting into the face of Shank Barzini is the man who is deemed too weak to wrestle. And Barzini trying to make his way back to the corner. Going to fight his way out, trying to make the tag, but cut off. And a tag in to Bo Sawyer. No eliminations yet. Between Team Stone and Team Not Dupree. Here, the start of the match, Dupree claiming he's, whoa. Charging in as Sawyer, Dupree claiming he's not eligible to wrestle. Doctor's orders. So Cecil Cerveza is in form, up and over goes O'Reilly. And Bo Sawyer, what's going on? Oh, right into it. Tornado Jones comes in, a little double tag team action. Flying drop kick in the corner. Shank Barzini wants some, picks up the man. A driver, one, two, three, and there goes the first man. Bo Sawyer is gone. And Dupree is one man down, Spencer Wallace. Now in there with Shank Barzini. And just firing off back and forth. Right hand to right hand, mano a mano. And Spencer. And now a tag into John Stone. Stone is in with Wallace. Wallace staggering around. Oh, now he sees he's got Stone. He's going to hit him with that knee. Nope, swing and a miss. Stone. Now comes in and fires into that top rope. Stone, look at this. Small package. Two, three, got him. Stone gets an elimination on Spencer Wallace. And two down now. It's Bradley Dupree's team. And charging in, Cecil Cerveza. He gets hit by Tornado Jones. To the gut. Up and over goes Tornado Jones into the ropes. Swing and a miss goes Cerveza. Jones off that second rope. Flying elbow. It's all going Johnstone team's way now. It's down to 4-2. Off the ropes now, and ooh, Cerveza catches him hard. Coming off that, Cerveza wasn't even in this match. Coming off, catches him. Ooh, tilt-a-whirl backbreaker. Haven't seen that one in a while. And a cover, 1-2, no kick out. Wow, momentum really just all of a sudden on John Stone's way. And now a tag team that never has worked before as far as I can tell. Vandy, and look at this. Brings him up for a stomp. Vandy with a cover. No, just a two. Vandy and Cerveza working together. It's 2-4. Right now, Jones and a man, in with a man about twice his size, and Vandy. Vandy pointing at Stone, but he better take care of Jones first. Jones trying to fire his way out of the corner, getting some momentum, but Vandy takes him, throws him into the corner, and hangs there like a pinata to be hit. And here he sees Cecil Cerveza working him over. The referee says, no, you can't come in and help. Vandy makes the tag to Cecil Cerveza. Make sure the referee sees it. Look at this. Maybe a, yep. Double suplex. Two bigger men trying to reach over for the tag. Jones is down. Stomp right in the middle. Just stomping away is Cecil Cerveza. Already eliminated, Bo Sawyer, the first elimination, and then Spencer Wallace. Dupree is down to two, spinning back kick. Up and over. And now, cover, 1-2. Oh, he was almost down to one. Now, Jones trying to reach over and get the tag. He's awful close. Look at Cerveza trying everything he can to keep him from making that tag. Holding on, trying to drag Jones over to his corner. He's got him up. Doesn't look like he's going to be able to make it. Spins around. Up. No, landing on his feet. One miss, roll through, tag, and in comes Shank Barzini. Cerveza goes down. Cerveza did not make the tag. And that headbutt, ooh, brings him up. Another driver, could be another driver. And there, for some reason, Dupree is up there. You got a chair in the ring. You got a chair in the ring. Cerveza has got the chair. Oh, and he nails him. And that's a disqualification, ref. That's a DQ. He's out of there. Oh, a big mistake. Barzini is down, but Cerveza is out. Disqualified. And now it's 1-4. Mark Vandy. Oh, nails the knee. That's going to be all. Good night. Yeah, Barzini is down after that chair shot in the knee. But it's still 3-1. It's still 3-1. The tag team champions. And Johnson, they're all in there. They're all in there. No, no, no. And Bradley Dupree says, no, 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 wait a second. No, no, wait a second. Vandy says, I'll take it. Drives in, nails the two tag team champions. And taking them out. And Dupree's in the ring with John Stone. I don't think that's what they wanted at all. I don't think that's what they wanted at all. Both the tag team champions outside. Vandy, they're blocking. Bam! Down goes Dupree. Stone took care of Dupree, but Vandy's behind him. Vandy's behind him. John, watch out! Oh, there it is. And John Stone goes down. Whoa, my.
John Stone has been eliminated.
And out of the ring, and he may be out cold. Wow, that was... When that knee hits, it hits. And John Stone has been eliminated. He got a lick on... And now Vandy's coming out to go after the tag team champions. It's one on two. He's going to continue to stomp on Stone. He's gone after Tornado Jones. It's one on two. Jones thrown in the ring. Vandy going after him. Jones. Suddenly the tide certainly switched in Dupree's favor. Jones thrown into the ropes. Vandy comes in, meets the knee, meets the foot, that is, of Jones. It's one on two. Jones tries to come. Oh! Telegraphed it. Vandy got out of the way. And he pulls Jones to the center of the ring. A cover. Two. No! He kicked out. Joey O'Reilly is still in this match, but tending to John Stone. Tornado Jones doesn't know where he is. Joey O'Reilly's got to get back to his corner. Now dragging him by the mask to the rope. Tornado Jones has taken a great deal of punishment. Mark Vandy pulls him back off. And Dupree is still down. But so is John Stone. I hope he's all right. Vandy against the tag team champions. It's one against two. And Jones. Oh, headbutt. And that staggered the both of them. But a cover now for Vandy. One, two. Wow, that was really close. I don't know how much more Jones will be able to take. Punching. Throws him almost to his corner. He almost got the tag. Almost a tactical mistake on Vandy's part. Vandy bringing him out to the center of that ring. And pointing at one of the fans. One of the fans. Oh, makes a tag. Made the tag, I believe. They try and go for the cover, but there's no count. And he lands it. Cover. One, two, three. It's all over. It's all over. What a maneuver by O'Reilly. And your winner, two survivors to none, is Team John Stone. What a war of attrition that was. But the tag team champions, and you see why, how they're able to work together so well. John Stone making his way back in the ring after taking that vicious knee from Vandy. But it's Team John Stone with the win in the natural selection match. And you can see his team raise his hand. Oh, Stone is out. Oh, but victorious. And Bradley Dupree's team has to lick their wounds as they head back. The winners of your natural selection match, Team John Stone. We're back with more.
So tonight's UWC event was called Natural Selection, and I think that's a fitting title for an event where I mopped the floor with that unevolved, slobbering mess, Norman. And as far as I can remember, this is the first time I've ever been in the ring with him. So I beat him on the first time, as far as I can remember. So, it's time for me to move on. Moving on to bigger and better things. People who can spell words and not drool all over themselves and maybe have big shiny gold belts around their waist? Maybe.
Thank you.
from Chicago, Illinois, he is homicidal Steven Davis.
With Blake Reed, who has just been plowing through the competition recently, up against Steven Davis. We've been looking forward to this one. Steven Davis has been looking forward to getting his hands on the championship. Blake Reed trying to get into the head of Steven Davis. I don't think that's going to work. Steven Davis has been around. And the two lock up. Two big men in there. Davis goes straight for the arm. And working the angles, slows arm, brings that left arm, bends that elbow a little bit, and going to the ropes is the champion. The Wabash Talent Agency earlier on this card suffered a defeat as Travis Weir lost the award on the pole match to Harker Dirge. Well, he's a little subdued and holding on to that championship belt for all it's worth. He's not used to losing in natural selection. He's usually got a team in natural selection, but not this time. And John Stone's team won natural selection this time. To the headlock goes Steven Davis. You'll see him take his time. Oh, not going to be able to throw him off that easily. Davis hangs on, now works on that left arm again. Is he chain wrestling by the veteran? Reversal and a double reverse. And that time the champion decides to go right for the eye. And a chop as he comes in. Elbow. Another elbow, and Davis starting to get some momentum. Backs the champion up almost to the corner and back to that arm wringer. Forces him to his knees now, trying to take some of the pressure off his Breed by doing this. But he just lines himself up with an elbow. And back to the arm again goes Davis. And we'll see if this plays dividends later in the match. I don't see a whole lot of super high impact moves right now, although that's pretty impact. And that knee, another knee. Maybe Davis is looking for a long one. And trying to break the man down piece by piece. But now it's coming to blows. Davis backs the man up into the corner. Walking away a little bit, Davis. Gonna get some momentum. Come in and... Whoa! Whoa! Gets the big man over with the monkey flip. And he's not used to that, is Blake Reed. And he goes down and outside the ring. Getting into it with some of the fans at ringside. Wabash trying to calm his man down. Davis knows he's not going to win any match on a countout. He's not going to win the title, so he grabs the champion by the hair. Tried to bring him in. And ends up getting caught across that top rope for his efforts. The champion breaks the count. Now brings Davis out. Brings him up and down. Down on the tile here. That's under that tile is concrete, folks. It's a gymnasium, but it's not wooden floors. And now Davis outside. He could get counted out here, making his way slowly up. The champion being smart. He doesn't have to be aggressive. Some champions defend defensively. As long as they don't lose, they keep the title. Davis makes his way into the ring. And Reed says it's over. And he brings him up. Nope. Getting behind him is Davis. Whoa! Tries to bring the big guy up, but can't. His back gives out. And now taking full advantage of that is Reed. Maybe tried to go a little early. and maybe try to bite a little bit too much of that apple. That time Davis, and now that back is going to be a huge problem against a huge athlete. Might have been a bit of a rare tactical mistake. Reed better take advantage of it. Pounding that right hand on that back. Reed taking a little time. Now goes for a cover. Well, that's not going to work. Barely a one. And now goes to work. I don't think that's quite locked on as a sleeper hold, but it certainly is going to put a lot of pressure on the neck and the spinal cord, the upper spinal cord of Stephen Davis. Davis going to try and grab the ear and work his way out that way. And that's how it works. Grab whatever you can and turn. And that's what happened. And again, punch to the back. And Reed is in control. Blake Reed, since he's won the title, and he won in a controversial fashion over Harker Dirge. Each opponent he's been in with, and some guys he hasn't even been in with. He just come in from the back, and he's just rolled over him. Oh, big giant leg drop. And the cover of Davis. One, two, and just a two. Just the two. Davis, a couple of shots to the midsection, and a chop, trying to make his way up, and a poke to the face. Right under the eye that time by Reed. And Reed drapes him across that bottom rope. Reed just taking his time. He knows he's got Stephen Davis hurt at back. Gave out as Reed tried to bring him. Now whips him into that corner, and again, that turnbuckle used as a weapon. And the back of Stephen Davis. Well, he's probably wondering if he packed a spare one in the back. Davis fires off from his knees. Probably not as much as he would like behind it. And Reed fires back. You could see Davis punching the mat. Probably more mad at himself that he's injured at this point. A true professional, Davis. He's firing back. Gets the man up. I'm trying to pick him up again, and just not happening. Not happening. And now, Reed with a power slam on that back. Davis is a strong man, but with an injured back, that's going to be tough to pull off. Cover. And a two. I don't care how strong you are. If your back is injured, it's going to be very, very tough to pick up a man the size of the champion. And the champion isn't going to help him. Reed spending a lot of time jawing with the fans and giving Davis time to catch his breath. And that cover, that's not going to work at that. Too much time. Now bouncing off the ropes. Comes up. No elbow. It wasn't a powerful roll away, but it was an effective one. And now Davis trying to make his way up. Certainly behind the eight ball with that back injury at this point. Tries to punch, lands a punch of his own, and a chop. And another punch. Kick doesn't go. Knocks him down. Another chop. Another chop. Pushed away into the ropes. Comes up. Misses. Davis just kicks him with the drop kick. Caught him with the drop kick. Staggered him into the corner. And now Davis coming up from behind. Grabbing the nose. And elbows to the face. You can see that back still bothering Davis. He's waiting for him to come up. He wants to finish him. Tries to bring him up again. It's just not going to work with that back at this point. Throws him into the corner, almost into the referee. And going to charge, but nobody there. He rolls away. Charge, spear. Down goes the champion. And a cover. One, two, and in the ropes. Sticky Wabash helping out. Davis thinks he won, but he did not. He didn't. I think his foot was headed toward the ropes anyway, but Wabash certainly helps. Now frustrated Stephen Davis in the middle of the ring. And that's it. That may be all. Reed is going away. He may have had enough of Stephen Davis. And Davis is going after him. Davis knows he's going to have to wrestle him. And the wrestler is going into the back. The referee counting one. Oh, he can see. He catches him before he got too far in the back. And a knee. Wabash. Think, oh, he almost got away, but he didn't. Now trying to get in. Is Stephen... Whoa, what's going on here? He's not going to suplex him back. No, no, no. He told the fans to move. Now, that shot. Whoa, no. Can't get him up. Oh, not getting him up. Oh! Flipped him over. He didn't land a suplex, but he did land. Comes off. Landed. Oh, is it good night? Two. And Stephen Davis is made of sterner stuff indeed. Boy, the fans making their way back to the chairs. They thought they were going to get a champion in their lap. Oh, now it may be Davis is going to have a champion in his lap. Oh, Reed looking at those ropes. He's climbing up to that second rope. Turning around, Davis moving out. He's not going to let that happen. He's got the champion stranded on the top rope. Oh, is he going to try to get him? No. It set itself up, but no, now he's down. The champion. Oh, look out, folks. No, he got out of the way. He got out of the way. Davis. And coming down like a ton of bricks, the champion, and he hasn't moved. We could have a double count. Now finally stirring a little bit is the champion. The referee's count is up to five. Davis making it to his knees. Six, the champion now getting it up. There is contact, so the count is broken. Both wrestlers back at it, exchanging right hooks. Davis getting some momentum off the ropes, but met. With a meat hook of a clothesline by the champion, Blake Reed. Reed hung out to dry on that top rope, trying to get some air. Wabash says, this is it. Reed says, this is it. He's got the, oh, look out. Oh, he got him up. He got him up. And down. Can he cover him? Yes. One, two. Oh, Wabash pulled him off. Wabash pulled him off. Oh, we just about had a new champion. Now, Davis is coming after Wabash. Oh, no for Wabash. Now Wabash being chased back. And he's in the ring. Oh, he's got Dickie Wabash. Wouldn't hit a man with glasses, would he? Well, the champion's right behind him. Now back up again, picked him up, and again the slam. And that should be all. One, two, three. And that's it, folks. Whoa, what an effort by Davis. He had the championship. Dickie Wabash does what he gets paid for. And defending his heavyweight championship is Blake Reed, but man, Davis put up a fight.
Thank you.
Term future, but I don't say I can agree with the way he's gone about it. Off the ropes, comes back, shoulder block, down goes Aaron. Oh, and a little pose in the corner for Jason V, a little taunt for Aaron Matthews. Jason trying to make the point that the outside distractions have kept him from maintaining the heights that he reached early in his career. And Jason V gets the arm ringer reversed on him, and down goes V. Working on that arm, Aaron Matthews. Rolling through. And a takedown. Well done, Arn, with the toe drag. Rolls it up. To a headlock. These two have wrestled many, many times. They were a champion tag team at one time. Not much to go to surprise each other with. Overwhelmingly, but never has either one of these wrestled with this much on the line. And the crowd getting behind Aaron Matthews, but will it be enough to beat the former UWC champion? And a man on the mission is Jason V. Into the corner goes Aaron Matthews. And a chop for Jason V coming out of it. He says this is for his own good. And again a chop. Well, turn around, fair play, and a chop by Aaron Matthews. And another chop. Going corner to corner, turn about again, and an elbow, and a big chop, that time by Jason V, and they go into the far corner. From us here in the crow seat. Oh, swing and a miss that time. Come back with a right hand is Aaron Matthews. Throws him off as Jason V. Pops him again, another chop. Brings him into the far corner again, another chop. Throws him off again as Jason V. This time, paint brushes him on the way in. Caught him in the eye and slaps him again. Did you want a fist fight? Yeah. behind Aaron Matthews. And he takes him down and just starts trying to pummel him. Covering up is Jason B. Throws him off. Back at him again, a kick. Into the ropes goes V. That drop kick. That best drop kick of the Midwest lands. Into the corner goes Jason V. Now, up reversal, into the ropes. V's waiting for him, but gets the boot instead. And V up and up and over and out. On the outside of that ring now. We've seen both these wrestlers. I have seen probably triple-digit number of wrestling matches these two have had. Right at that steel on the side of the ring. Aaron Matthews needs to stay on top of his men. If you lose by countout, he loses. Jason B. taking his time outside. Say, come on, get in this ring. He's not going to take a win by countout. Jason B. taking his time. Moving slowly is V. And he gets into the ring. Punch to the side of the head, a second punch to the side of the head. Now a reversal into the ropes, comes out, misses that time, does V, misses the second time. Cross body, switched around, and V got the top. Almost got the three. Tried a cross body, but it was reversed in mid-move. Arm wringer and a knee lift. Well done bit of wrestling there by V. Now, it's a punch to the side of the head. Crowd trying to get inside the head of Jason B, but he's on a mission here. Fires him into that second turnbuckle. And boots that rope. Crowd still trying to get into the head of Jason V. And into that ring corner again. Tries to rip to the far corner. It is Jason V that goes instead. Comes in and meets the knee. There's Aaron Matthews from that second rope. Ooh, plants him. You could see that head bounce off the canvas. And Matthews may be out. This could be it. Nope. Jason V pushes him up. Oh, what's he going here? Is he going for that knee? Is he going for that foot? Is he going to go for the kick? Oh, this could be it, folks. He stopped. Why'd he stop? He had it. Why did he stop? And look at this. Oh, he's got him in a sugar hold. It's the submission hold right here. Jason V had him and absolutely had him. All set up for that kick that's finished so many wrestlers, and he just up and stopped. Now, you see how he's got that leg hooked around. V escapes. A couple of knees to the side of the head and rolls it up. Now, into a key lock of his own, and this could be a submission. He's got to watch it, though, because his shoulders are down as well. Nope, he's keeping it up. Referee gets a look. It doesn't look like he's quite got the angle he needs. And getting to the ropes is Aaron Matthews. Oh, my. You want to play submissions, and Jason V's got them all. Oh, you see, working that right arm, the good arm, is all he's got left. That left one is damaged pretty well. Drop toe hold right into the ropes and pow, right up the side of the head. Aaron Matthews now moving up. He's going to that top rope. He's going to the top rope, but he's pushed off. Wow, into the front row. Pushed off into the front row. Referee, count him. Tell the referee to count him. And he's far away from the ring. He's well away from the ring. I don't know how he's going to get back in 10. Fans trying to help him out. He's wandering away from the ring. He's not getting any closer. It's 8. 8. 9, and he dove in. He dove in, beat the count. V thought he had him by count out, but he just got in. Now, working him off that second rope. I can't understand why, maybe a twinge of regret. He didn't take that kick earlier, but he certainly wanted to win by a count out. Look at this. Snapmare, and again, oh, really bending that elbow back. Another submission move. He doesn't want Aaron to just lose, he wants him to quit. And that's essentially what he would be doing. He would be quitting wrestling if he loses this match. Now working the fingers against each other, that is not a legal move. We've seen it taken a lot of, he's taken a lot of punishment before and come back to win.
They love you! They love you! And you're going to do nothing but disappoint them!
Oh, just in the face. Still continuing with a verbal barrage is Jason V.
That's it,
oh, no. He says that's it. Slaps him. Pushes him back. Atomic drop and a punch. Down goes Jason V, trying to come back. Right hand, V goes down again. Doesn't get him that time. Whoa! And you see the tingling in the fingers as he hit on that one. Going to the top again. Going to the top, maybe. This could be all. This could be it. This could save his career. Coming off the top. Landing! The cover! 1, 2! And Jason V rolls out. Matthews, he's got to come back in this one. No, elbow. Jason V's got some left. He says, come on. Come on! Oh, look at this. Oh my! And then he hasn't... I haven't seen him for that move in years! I mean, two... I mean, that... Then he hasn't done that... I mean, that was a finisher for him, and I'm really surprised he pulled that out. He's really... gone back in the bag of tricks, really wanting to win this match. And now, both wrestlers... exhausted. V. Oh, gets caught that time. The knee. Straps him on that top rope, another chop. V. He's gonna get some momentum, comes off. Oh, he eats the boot that time. Second rope. Flying forearm sends V down. Flying forearm sends V down. You can see the face of Aaron Matthews. He's fighting for his ring career here. Jason V is up, ready for the boot. He nailed it. He got him that time. That could be it, folks. 1, 2, no! No, no! Well, he held up the first time, but not the second time. And that'll show you this time, Mr. V, that Aaron Matthews has got a little more fight in him than you think. No, he says. He's still going after it, trying to make his way to his feet. Trying to make his way to his feet. He says, come on. Come on. He's got him ready. If he can land that boot. No, he misses. Into the corner. Top rope, lands it. 1, 2, 3! There you go, folks. Your winner is Aaron Matthews. That's natural selection. At UWC. For everyone in the back, I'm Eric Loy up in the crow's nest. We'll see you in Georgetown.